Fran, darling. Yes. Fancy meeting you here at the doctor's office. Is everything okay?
Girl, my arthritis is acting up, is all. Mm-hmm. How about you? How you doing?
I'm here for my osteoporosis. Apparently my bones make peanut brittle. Seem flexible in comparison. Ooh, is it hot in here? Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, I'm burning up.
Girl, it's not the temperature. You probably had one of those hot flashes. Last night I had a big one. I felt like putting the frozen peas all over my body. But Bill told me, he said, put whipped cream on you. No. You know Bill, that pig.
That sounds like Bill. He's just too funny.
Yeah. Why, look at that. Here comes Karen.
Apparently my bones are breaking.
Pat.
Hi. How you doing? Good to see you.
You look so lovely, both of you.
Thank you.
Why are you here? Nothing serious, I hope.
Apparently, my bones are breaking down and Fran's joint creeps.
Speak up.
Fran's joint bones creeps worse than an outhouse door. Mm-hmm. What about you, dear? Just here for a checkup?
I ache all the time. I ache so much that I have to drag myself down to the bingo hall. I get a migraine every time Charles is near me. He only wants one thing, you know.
Yeah, you know what he wants.
Uh-oh, the doctor's calling me. I'll be right back.
You know, I think once you turn 50, everything falls apart. Just like my houseplant, the leaves just falls off.
I don't know about you, honey, but gravity makes everything go straight down.
I hear you. I feel bad about Pat's arthritis, but you know they said that comes from drinking too much.
I don't know how Pat drinks every night, especially since Norman is losing his job.
Oh, I know. Maybe they found out he has an addiction for gambling. Mm-hmm. Oh, I was supposed to say that. Swear you won't tell nobody. Don't tell nobody else.
My lips are sealed. You can tell me anything.
Girl, me too. I certainly would never gossip.
Mm-hmm.
I certainly would never gossip. Not like Pat. She loves a gal. Mm-hmm. But why? Last week she told me about Carol and Vince having an affair. Mm-hmm. Say that. After Callie, she swore to Callie that she wouldn't tell anyone.
Carol and Vince? I knew it.
I think I hear Pat coming.
Well, I got a needle right here.
Let's see if it works.
Fran. I think they're calling you Fran.
Okay, girls. Wish me luck.
I'll wait here for a bit till the pain in my butt leaves.
I hope you're not talking about me.
Oh, no, Karen.
You're talking about that injection.
Oh, no, Karen. I'm fine. You're fine. It's Fran. She can be funny acting sometimes.
I know what you mean. Did you see her hair? Oh, it looked like she teased it with a salad fork.
She really lets herself go sometimes. I wonder if she has early Alzheimer's. Or something.
I bet she has a cotton house, but she wears around the house, right?
Oh, I'm sorry. No, just Karen. Mm-hmm. I wonder if she has a horse.
Huh? I wonder too, of course.
I wouldn't talk about her appearance, but she is dressing kind of bad lately.
Mm. I bet she has a cotton house dress she's wearing around the house, right?
Oh my God.
My gosh, it's so hot in here. Oh, here comes Fran. So Fran,
Wait, Fran.
Hey girls, I'm back.
Oh, so Fran, what are they going to do about your joints pain?
The doctor gave me a stronger painkiller, and if I needed more, he'd give me more. But it could make me loopy. I could fall and break my hip.
I heard that when you reach our age, hip replacement is mandatory.
Remember, we can help. Just say the word.
Oh, you guys are so wonderful. Thank you so much. Thank you for caring. Thank you, Pat. Well, I'm off. Good luck, guys. You looking to see if I'm gone?
Did you hear that Fran was stopped by the cops for speeding? And she had the nerve to sweet talk the cop.
That's the end, ladies.
$10,000. Show is wonderful, Mommy. $10,000? You know what you should do, Miss Lena? You should take yourself a trip somewhere to Europe or South America, anywhere, someplace.
Oh, child.
I am serious. Just pack your bag and leave. Go away and enjoy yourself. Some. Forget about the family and have yourself a ball for once in your life.
You sound like I'm about ready to die. Who's going with me? Well, I look like wandering around Europe by myself.
Shoot, these white women just do it all the time. I'm sorry. Shoot, these white women, they do it all the time. They don't think about nothing but packing up their suitcase and pulling out on a big steamship and swoop, they gone, child.
Something always told me I wasn't no rich white woman.
Well, what are you going to do with them?
I ain't rightly decided. Some of it got to be put away for Benita and her schooling, and ain't nothing going to touch that part of it, nothing. Been thinking that we maybe could meet the notes on a little old two-story somewhere with the yard where Travis could play in the summertime if we use part of the insurance for a down payment. And everybody can kind of pitch in. I could maybe take on a little day work again. 4 days a week, a few days a week.
Lord knows we put enough rent into that rat trap to buy us at least 4 houses by now.
Rat trap. Yes, that's all it is. I remember just as well the day me and Big Walter moved in here. Hadn't been married but 2 weeks. And wasn't planning on living no more than a year. We was going to set away little by little, don't you know, and buy a little place out in Morgan Park. We had even picked out the house. Looks right dumpy today, but Lord, child, you should know all the dreams I had about buying that house and fixing it up and making a little garden in the back. And did none of it happen?
Yes, life can be a barrel of disappointment sometimes.
Big Walter would come in here. Oh, honey, Big Walter would come in here some nights back then and slump down on that couch there and just look at the rug. And look at me, and look at the rug, and then back at me. And I know he was down and really down. And then, Lord, when I lost that baby, little Claude, I almost thought I was going to lose Big Walter, too. Oh, that man grieved himself. He was one man to love his children.
Ain't nothing like caring at your loss at your child, your baby.
I guess that's how come that man finally worked himself to death like he done, like he was fighting his own war with this here world that took his baby from him.
He sure was a fine man, all right, Mr. Younger.
Crazy about his children. God knows there was plenty wrong with Walter Younger. Hard-headed, mean, kind of wild with women. Plenty wrong with him, but he sure loved his children. Always wanted them to have something, be something. That's where brother gets all these notions, I reckon. Big Walter used to say he'd get right wet in the eyes sometimes, lean his head back, with the water standing in his eyes and stuff. Seemed like God didn't see fit to give the black man nothing but change. But he did give us children to make them dreams seem worthwhile. He can talk like that, didn't you know?
Yes, he sure could. He was a good man, Mr. Younger.
Yes, a fireman. Just couldn't never catch up with his dreams, that's all.
Dark phrase of the womanhood of never had been a girl. Have notes scattered without rhythm. No tune distrusted. Her laughter falling over. Black girl's shoulder. It's funny, it's hysterical. No melody in her dance. Don't tell nobody. Don't tell a soul. She dances on beer cans and shingles. She dances. Don't tell nobody. Don't tell a soul. Are we animals? Are we crazy? I can't hear anything but madness and scream and the soft strain of death. And you promised me somebody, anybody, sing a black girl's song, bring her out to herself.
rhythm, carrying her struggle, singing a song of life. She been dead so long. She been dead so long, clothes and sorrow so long. She doesn't know the song of her own voice. Her infinity beauty sing a song of her personality. Sing the right gospel. Let her be born again.
Why not?
I don't understand you. That child that's coming, that's your grandchild. That's your grandchild. What difference does it make how it got here? The child ain't got nothing to do with that. Ain't none of us got nothing to do with that.
Gary, don't you think I have hopes and dreams? Did it ever cross your mind that I might want to know other men who might make me laugh and feel good? You are not the only one who had wants and needs. But I took all my wants and needs and my dreams, and I buried them all inside of you.
Ella? All my life I had to fight. I had to fight my daddy. I had to fight my uncles. And I had to fight my brothers. A girl, child, and sister, family, me. But I ain't never thought I would have to fight in my own house. Papa, I love you, but I'll kill you dead.
That one wasn't hard to figure out.
Not at all.
Okay, Alexis.
Somebody almost walked off with all my stuff. What can anybody do with something of no value on an open market? Did you get a dime for my stuff? Hey, you, where you going with all my stuff? That's my stuff you got in your hand. That's my heart you got there. Oh, Lord, honest to God, somebody almost ran off with all my stuff.
Okay, I don't understand you. That child is coming. Where is that from? Anybody know?
his right to do what is right.
Bring your sister on.
God does not give anything to those with their arms crossed.
Bring your sister on.
Just don't give up.
Sorry.
Just don't give up what you're trying to do. Where there is love and inspiration, I don't think you can go wrong.
Bring your sister.
He who is not courageous enough to take risks will accomplish nothing in life. We may encounter many defeats, but we must not be defeated.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that.
Amen. Mm-hmm. That's right.
Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that.
Come on, yes. Say that.
Amen. Amen.
Where there is no vision, there is no hope.
That's right.
Amen. Last but not least, we all see what struggles are going on in the world today. It might be just your personal one, wars and rumors of wars. Mm-hmm. But believe me, just remember, if there's no struggle, there's no progress.